Hey guys, Kristen Shea here. And you've probably heard that when you're marketing or you're crafting a message to get somebody's attention, you want to be talking to your audience, to your clients. And what is a generally accepted best practice and way to do that is by talking to the you. Are you prepared for retirement? Do you have life insurance? What kind of fees are you paying on your investment portfolio? And I'm not saying that that's bad advice, because the alternative is usually just to say blah, 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 retirement planning and hope that it catches their attention. But I want to share with you an alternative that I thought was really, really interesting. For Christmas, I bought my fiance and I packages for Masterclass. It's like an at-home course database led by experts all over the world for a bunch of different stuff. And one of the ones that I was watching was led by Daniel Pink, who is a world-renowned sales expert. And he shared this story, a real true story. There's a hospital down in North Carolina, and the purpose of the study was to figure out what type of messaging would increase the hand-washing rates of, you know, the nurses, the doctors, the staff at the hospitals. So they put up three signs to test the different messages. The first one was, washing your hands prevents you from catching disease. The second one said, hand-washing prevents patients from catching disease. And the third one had this very catchy phrase that said, gel in, wash out. So there were two signs that had no impact at all, and there was one that made a significant increase or impact on the rate that these people at the hospital were washing their hands. Despite all the predictions and what makes sense, gel in, wash out was the one that made a difference. Just kidding, it was definitely not. But it also wasn't washing your hands prevents you from catching disease. What it actually was, which I didn't expect, was washing your hands prevents patients from catching disease. And I don't know about you, but I didn't expect that to be the outcome. I thought it was really interesting. And at the end of the day, the reason for that is because there is a higher purpose that these nurses and doctors are serving, right? Which is helping patients. So think about your client base. What do they care about more than just themselves? What about your services makes the world a better place, makes a difference for other people around them that they care about? And if you know who your ideal audience is, or even just the prospect or the client that you're talking to, make your messages personal by talking to the things that they care about, as opposed to just the you. Hope this helps, and cheers.